y'all. I'm Barbie from Barbie and the Caveman, where a balanced table is a happy table. Now, I'm a casual vegan, and my husband's a carnivore, and my little egg's complicated. So my purpose is to take vegan recipes and adapt them to any diet. Join me today for Barbie and the Caveman. Hey y'all, it's really cooling down here in the south, and sadly, all the ice storms up north are making it even colder. So the caveman left today on his next trip, and I'm gonna use that opportunity to make some greens. Oh yes, I'm gonna start with a big pot up on high heat. Now, this is made from kale and collards, right in time for the new year. I know you gotta get your collards in, gotta get your money. Start with 2 cloves of chopped garlic. I put it down into the oil. And this is just simply a wintergreen casserole. Now, us Southerners love our casseroles, as you know, with the squash and with the green beets that I've done in the past. So stay tuned, you're gonna love it, I promise. So as it comes up to high heat, now I have been chopping this. This is a huge bowl of greens and collards. Now you can get this at, you know, your local grocery store, or of course, you know me in the garden, gotta go out there and scavenge what you can find. So that's what we have done. Next, I'm gonna add a whole chopped and diced yellow onion. Now, I love the yellow onion. It gives a really nice flavor, a full-bodied flavor, where the sweet onion is very, very mellow. Now, if you're really brave and you want some really pretty color down in there, say instead of kale, you wanna use some rainbow chard or some Swiss chard, then chop up a red onion and throw it in there. It'll make a beautiful medley of colors down in your pot and get you all ready for the new year. Excuse my Santa spatula. And I'm just a little bit of season. So, let me come up to heat. There we go. So then, now with this, I'm going to use a nice, just Le Creuset casserole pan. So as this comes up to heat, I am just going to spray the bottom with a nice layer of cooking spray. Now mostly this is just habit. I just really don't like it to stick. And we're going to put in some nice vegetarian cheese and even some almond cream cheese with panko bread and crumbs on the top. It's delicious, you're gonna love it. So now, as you can start seeing that the smoke is coming out of the pot, and we see that the onions are starting to get a little translucent. Now, with this massive amount of greens, if you don't have a really deep pot, or maybe you want to use a really big wok, that also works really well. Layer in the greens, and sometimes you have to do it in batches. All right, so I'm just gonna start grabbing them, throwing them in through the greens very carefully when I was shredding them. Whoop, I missed one. To pull out any of the stems. You really don't want to use any of the stems, and just start to throw out your compost. You don't want to use the stems because to bite into it, it's not gonna cook down as nice and dainty as the leaves are going to. So there we go. All those greens down into that pot. Push them down in there. Listen to that sizzle. So you put the greens down in the pot, add 1/2 cup of really nice vegetable broth. Give it a nice stir. Cover and let it just sit for quite a bit and let those greens wilt. Maybe take 6, 7, sometimes 8 minutes depending upon how woody or how thick your collards or your kale is. So we'll check back in a sec. Now, we're back. So now, woo, the collards have cooked down really nicely in the kale. So from here, we're gonna add in some nutritional yeast. Probably 2 tablespoons or so. A nice tablespoon of brewer's yeast. Now these are a lot of your B vitamins that you can really infuse into what you're making and really add some nutritional powerhouse kicks to the already amazing benefits of the green. Nice tablespoon of vegan butter. and about a teaspoon of just liquid aminos to give it a nice salty flavor. Stir to combine. So nice. Now I'm gonna start throwing in my spices. Use some ginger, thyme, and sage. All very warming spices, as you notice, because baby, it's cold outside. We love to keep our casseroles nice and warm. Some sea salt and some fresh ground pepper. Now again, I love to use the three pepper medley. It just gives a nice balanced taste to the pepper instead of just the black pepper. You know, and of course black pepper has its place, its time, but I prefer using the pepper medley when it's something that I want the taste to be a little more delicate. So now, ready, about to know all my secrets. Almond cream cheese, y'all. Seriously, where were we before almond cream cheese? I put in 2 great big tablespoons of almond cream cheese. Just throw the spoon down in there and let it melt into those greens. That cup of vegan cheese. Now I've turned my heat down to low, so we can incorporate these cheeses without scalding them or causing them to make some kind of film on the bottom of the pot, which is just awful. And you don't want to wash it anyway. Ooh, makes that stuff on the bottom of the pot. The only way to get that off, here's a little side trick, is baking soda. All right. Baking soda, put it in the pot with a little bit of water and then bring it to a boil like you're boiling eggs. And let it boil pretty hard for about 10 minutes. And then just let it cool, and then use your spatula, scrape it right off. Nice and easy. Easy peasy. All right, so now, here we go. Look how creamy and how beautiful those greens have cooked down to. And then, we are going to, in our casserole pan, just layer it into a casserole pan. Ah, smells so good. It just smells so yummy. So, just layer it down into your pan, like so. Get about 1/2 cup panko breadcrumbs. Layer across the top. Now, if you find that this is not enough in the way of greens, feel free to go back to the drawing board. Just refill your bowl, just start over and layer in another layer. Even if the panko crumbs are on and you want to add another layer, layer it up like lasagna. It's also fantastic. Okay. Now, guilty pleasure here, y'all. Veggie bacon. I can hardly do anything without veggie bacon. Where was life before veggie bacon? I don't know, maybe I didn't have any. So then, now, I spray it again with cooking spray, just because I want those panko bread crumbs to really brown and to crisp and to look really nice and get a nice smoky texture to them. So, last thing. And this you can add or you cannot, depending totally on how your family feels about cheese, is I just sprinkle a little more of the vegan cheese on top. I'll pop this in the oven at 350 for about 30 minutes or so till it gets nice and toasty and bubbly. And then we'll check back and I'll show you the finished product. It's terrific with crackers, by the way, if you're hosting a nice little New Year's Eve party or any of this. And we're back, it's out of the oven. Now, ooh, the smell is fantastic. and I gotta be honest with you, some of the best ways to eat this is just with a chip. Cheesy, green, veggie, savory, all the wonderful things that you want in your dip or in your casserole. Feel free to share, subscribe, make sure you like, and share with your friends. I look forward to seeing you next time on Barbie and the Caveman. Bye, y'all.